In this video, we're going to look at the bones of the lower limb, and here on this benchtop, we have them in an articulated fashion, looking at the anterior surfaces, starting with the femur. Moving down, you can see the femur at its distal end articulates with the tibia. Just lateral to the tibia, we have the fibula, which is a stabilizer bone. And then at the distal end of the tibia, we have the foot, and it will articulate with the foot at the talus. Let's move back up to the femur. Looking at this anterior view, we can see the femoral head, the anatomic neck. If we rotate this just a little bit, you can see this fovea capitis, this indentation where the femoral ligament once secured the femoral head in the acetabulum of the ascoxal bone. Moving down this anterior surface, we have the patellar surface at the distal end of the femur. When the leg is extended, this is roughly where the patella will reside. We turn the femur over, you can still see the anatomic neck, and we see a lesser and greater trochanter here. Again, the greater and lesser trochanters, these are where muscles will attach. Just below these areas, or inferior, we have this gluteal tuberosity, this roughened area where the gluteus maximus muscle will attach. Moving down the posterior of the femur, we have the linea aspera, this sharpened ridge. And then opposite the patellar surface, we have the popliteal surface back here. Then you'll notice these two articular surfaces. They are respectively the medial and lateral condyles in this view. This is a posterior view. If we rotate this over, the medial would obviously then be on the other side. We also can see this intercondylar fossa or space. When we rotate this back over, looking at the anterior view, you can still see the articular surfaces of the lateral and medial condyles, and then these areas just above there would be the lateral and medial epicondyles.